Americans in debt, and a new report from the Federal Reserve showing that consumer debt rose 7.5% at the end of last year. Much of that was racked up on credit cards. Well, tonight we meet a woman at the extreme who says she can't stop charging even things she doesn't need. Here's ABC's Cecilia Vega.
I want it. I want it now.
Clothes, shoes, housewares.
I think I'll get these. These are really cute.
It's going to be about $80 just by itself.
Just by itself. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's cool.
You name it, Ronnie Herring wants to buy it. For most people, a trip to the mall is, well, just a trip to the mall. For Ronnie, it's a universe of dangerous temptations. Because Ronnie is a shopaholic.
When you come to a place like this, do you feel like you want to go shopping?
Yes. Well, it's more than wanting to go. It's a feeling of needing to go.
The term shopaholic has become shorthand to describe the legions of women who love to shop. But Ronnie is among the estimated 6% of Americans struggling with compulsive shopping.
Hey, great day.
A roller coaster ride of endorphin-fueled highs and guilt-ridden lows.
Sears, $2,700.
Today, Ronnie's credit card debt is more than $50,000. That's on top of the $50,000 she borrowed against her last home.
I've been trying to get a hold of you for a little while now.
She says she has no choice but to declare bankruptcy.
That would be a typical creditor that I would usually not even listen to.
Bill, Ronnie's husband of almost 20 years, works two jobs to keep the family afloat. And he says enough is enough.
Over $100,000 in debt because of your shopping.
Yes.
Is that number infuriating to you?
It's to the point where you just like to throw in the towel and walk away.
At what point did you go from being a girl who likes to shop to being someone who's considered a compulsive shopper?
I just think it was so slowly escalating that you didn't realize it until it was all over.
It started as a young girl wanting the latest fashion, then later as a mom wanting the newest toys for her two kids. Soon she was shopping in secret, hiding new things from her husband.
And he'd say, is that something new? And I'm, no, I've had this for a while.
When she maxed out her credit cards, she then moved on to her husband's.
She goes to the extreme of copying down the card numbers and hiding them. She's even went to the point to call the bank and disguise her voice as me.
How is it possible for a woman to lose it all over clothes and shoes?
I need three.
All it takes is one shopping trip with Ronnie to see.
But then I don't want just 1 cent. So then I want to come over here and pick up five of this kind.
10 bottles of soap?
Probably 15.
Part of her compulsion, she buys everything in sets.
I have to cover every possible outcome. You know, if you're gonna do it right. So the only way to do it right is to get to do all of it.
Back at home in her wardrobe, dozens of identical pairs of shirts. And when Ronnie finally went completely broke, she still went shopping. She just couldn't afford to pay for what she took.
And the only way to fill the want is to take things, to take the place of the things you would have bought before.
Last month, Ronnie was busted. This Midwestern soccer mom was cuffed, fingerprinted, and thrown into a cell.
It was kind of like, you've hit rock bottom now. There's nowhere to go.
Ronnie says it was the wake-up call she needed.
Oh my God, my babies are at home. This isn't acceptable. You have to be home. You need to be with your kids. This is destroying you.
You admit that you were powerless over your shopping?
A few days later, Ronnie desperately reached out to shopping addiction specialist Terry Schulman.
There's a core of low self-esteem or insecurity that I'm not good enough with who I am. When she feels anger or sadness or emptiness, she wants to fill that void. The problem is it's unfillable.
Terry takes Ronnie to her favorite stores to teach her how to look but not buy.
You know, I see the Sesame Street characters and, of course, we love all of them. I need to get all of them.
That urge to buy things in sets, Terry says it stems from Ronnie's childhood when her parents got divorced.
And it's almost like you don't want to separate them.
There's a feeling of being abandoned or being rejected. Having to, you know, just pick one was like taking away from a family.
For Ronnie, recovery could take years of therapy, but the first steps include strict new rules.
We have one checkbook with just my name on it. If she wants to write a check, then I have to sign my name to the check.
You're kind of the dad of a teenage girl in some ways.
You got it. That's exactly what I've said myself.
It'll be under $50 or something.
It is Chloe's 10th birthday, and Bill is trusting Ronnie to buy the party supplies.
I'm worried.
to make sure she doesn't spend too much.
And I don't need any of this other stuff that normally I would buy, so I'm just gonna walk away from that.
Ronnie has clearly made progress, but she doesn't know if she'll ever be fully cured. What she does know now is how much her addiction has cost her.
But will you ever be able to go back into a store and feel like it's okay to walk out without buying something?
Yes, I will get there because I can't not do that. I have to do that or I'm going to end up in jail or lose my family. And that's too high a price to pay.
For Nightline, I'm Cecilia Vega in Lansing, Michigan.